Hello and welcome to episode number 32 of WITM Season 8. And spooky season may have ended a month ago in real life, but it's just culminating here in the WITM universe as it is time for NXT Halloween Havoc. And we have a stat card for you here on this episode featuring three WITM matches, two of them involving titles on the line. The first of which is going to be a fatal four-way ladder match with the NXT North American Championship suspended high in the air and the winner claiming the NXT North American Championship. Defending that championship will be Carmelo Hayes, the man who defeated WITM's Cabbages for that title about a universe month ago. He will only have a 25% chance of retaining as he has three opponents, that being the former champion WITM's Cabbages, the leader of the NXT Falcon Claws, as well as the other two men who also won qualifying matches to earn the right for this opportunity, Von Wagner and Axiom. And then, for the first time since the reveal, we will have a match between the Falcon Claws and the Smile Society as Corey, in his first match, unless you count him as a masked man, since his return, is going to be taking on the man he hired to learn information about the Smile Society, who then turned on Corey and his offer and joined the Smile Society himself. Cowboy Cameron Grimes wrestling for the first time representing the Smile Society. Will Corey get his revenge, or will the Smile Society continue to dominate the Falcon Claws as they have over the past month? And then last but not least, we have a huge main event, as it's going to be Tony D'Angelo defending the NXT Championship against the top two contenders, the former NXT United Kingdom Champion, Ilya Dragunov, and the man who got injured last time he had opportunity for the title and now finally gets a second chance here, Tyger Brown, looking to become NXT Champion. But first, it is that fatal four-way ladder match with the NXT North American Championship literally hitting it in the balance, with Carmelo Hayes defending against Cabbages, Von Wagner, and Axiom. Let's get Halloween Havoc underway with this ladder match.
Like,
And there's the bell. This fatal four-way ladder match for the NXT North American Championship is underway as the defending champion Carmelo Hayes gets dumped outside but is able to reverse Axiom's attempt at a suicide dive. Meanwhile, Cabbages with the Pele kick from the ground to Von Wagner. And a beautiful maneuver there on Axiom, the man formerly known as A-Kid. The defending champion Hayes wasting no time. He's bringing a ladder into play. But massive suplex by Von Wagner, who has other plans. Cabbages with a reversal. Here comes Hayes, the man who defeated Cabbages in the past to earn that North American title. Can Cabbages get revenge? Cabbages missing with whatever he was attempting there. Ladder leaned into the corner and now brought back into play by Wagner, who's trying to use it as a weapon. Cabbages reverses Axiom. Now fights off Wagner. It seems like there's a double team on him. Cabbages is going to head outside to try to recover here. Hayes sent to the ladder. And drop kick by Wagner takes him out. Cabbages is going to bring another ladder into play. Axiom busted open. Cabbages, what does he have in mind here? He has a ladder making a bridge between the ring and the barricade. Now he uses the ladder already in the ring and sets it up near the center. Not quite sure that's going to be in the right spot, though, to ascend and get the title. Wagner to the outside. Hayes dumped the top of that ladder that Cabbages placed. Axiom and Cabbages now on top of the ladder under the belt. Axiom taken out by Wagner. Opportunity for Cabbages if he can reach the belt, and he can. Cabbages are going to start playing the minigame to unhook that belt, but after unlocking one of the locks, Cabbages hanging by the title belt and sit into a ladder by Von Wagner. Wagner with a kick to the back. Hayes and Axiom fighting on the outside. Axe handle to the back of Cabbages. Cabbages dumped outside by Wagner. Axiom now in the ring. And he's sent to the outside. Cabbages back in the ring. And Hayes is going to fight off Wagner. Axiom now back to the ring. Cabbages with a slam. Hayes dumped into the canvas. Cabbages blocks Wagner and sends him headfirst into his knee. Axiom with the snake eyes on Cabbages, using that top rope to his advantage. And Cabbages will head to the outside to recover, where Von Wagner is waiting. Axiom with a impressive maneuver, setting the defending champion Hayes head first into the ladder. But Hayes responds with a dropkick and now looking for a finisher perhaps. Meanwhile, Cabbages sends Wagner into the barricade. Axiom taken out by Hayes, and Hayes now setting up that ladder. But Axiom is in the way. Cabbages and Wagner continue to fight on the outside. Hayes and Axiom continue to find the inside. Axiom's head is in the red zone, as is Wagner's. Already two men at risk of injury. As Cabbages continues to dominate Wagner on the outside. Cabbages bringing yet another a chair into play. And he's going to use it as a weapon to take out the defending champion Hayes. Getting a little revenge here. And again, using the chair on Carmelo Hayes. But Hayes knocks out of the hands of Cabbages. And sends him onto the ladder that Cabbages put into play. Using his own weapon against him. Is Hayes going to do what I think he's going to do? Yes! Drop kick by Hayes onto that ladder that Cabbages put into play. Bending the middle of the ladder and destroying it. What a huge move there by Hayes. High risk but high reward. Hayes doing whatever it takes to retain the title, but Cabbages kips up and leaps into the air and taunts. What resilience by Cabbages. He's back to the ring. Asins, Wagner head first into the canvas. Opportunity here for Cabbages with everybody out of play except for him. Cabbages goes back after the defending champion, but Hayes is able to reverse. All four men now back to their feet. Cabbages continuing to make a target of Hayes. But Hayes reverses, but Wagner is waiting. Now Cabbages goes after Wagner. He hits the green mist and the punt kick, stunning Wagner. He's going to head to the outside to recover. Axiom reversed by Cabbages, who hits the elbow drop. Now Cabbages with a springboard DDT. But there's Hayes with a massive DDT, spiking Cabbages head first into the canvas. Kick to the back by Hayes, who's taken out by Wagner. Cabbages heads to the outside to recover. Wagner has the chair and attacks Hayes. Cabbages, the only man not at risk of injury at the moment. Cabbages back into the ring. And has the ladder, with everybody else either down or distracted, but there is Axiom spoiling his plans and sending the Cabbages to the apron. And rather than continue to attack Cabbages, Axiom is going to set up the ladder here, but not to try to retrieve the title. He's going to set up in the corner as a weapon. Meanwhile, Hayes brings another ladder into play. And he's going to do as Cabbages did earlier and make it a bridge between the ring and the barricade. And now taunts Cabbages. Hayes sent to the barricade. Cabbages with the green mist, but it barely phases Axiom, who hits a dropkick and stuns him. Cabbages now at risk of injury as well. Hayes maybe thinking high risk yet again, but elects not to this time. Hayes with a super kick to the head of Cabbages. Cabbages now biding his time, going after Axiom. He was ready. Hayes laid on top of that ladder that he put into play. Cabbages sent to the ropes and suplexed by Axiom. Headbutt by Wagner. Wagner now has the ladder, but doesn't realize that Hayes is behind him, but is able to reverse. Hayes with a super kick to the head of Wagner. Cabbages down, but starting to use the ropes to get back to his feet. Now taking a moment to rest on the ropes. Axiom has the ladder now and uses it to take out Wagner. We haven't seen anybody actually set it up to try to retrieve the title in a while. Axiom using the ropes to wear down the legs of Cabbages and now hits the Pele kick. Cabbages now has two body parts in the red zone as A-Kid perhaps looking, Axiom rather, perhaps looking for a finisher here. And that will connect, stunning Cabbages. Now with a dropkick, he barely faces Hayes and Hayes hits the roundhouse. Cabbages stunned on the outside, Wagner just coming to his senses. Hayes and Axiom fighting in the ring. Cabbages back to his feet. All four men now in the ring. Cabbages takes out Wagner. Axiom stunned. Hayes with a reversal on Cabbages with a series of gut punches. Cabbages drop kicked by Hayes. Wagner with a big boot to Hayes. Cabbages already back into the ring to try to fight Wagner. But reversal by Wagner. Cabbages gets behind Wagner and sends his legs into the ladder. Now Cabbages stomping away at Axiom. Cabbages with a massive DDT, sending Hayes head first into the chair. And now the green mist on Axiom, who is injured now. Axiom stunned and heading outside, taking the ladder with him. Cabbages with a reversal on Wagner. And he sends him into the canvas. Now transition to Hayes. Drop kick to Hayes. And now, thought he was taking firm handshake, but instead it's going to be a massive leg drop with Hayes' head dangling over the ropes. Cabbages brings him under the ladder from outside into play. Hayes dumped outside. Wagner stomping away at Cabbages. He'll head outside. Snake eyes by Wagner, who continues to attack Axiom. Thought he might take the opportunity to put the ladder in play for the title here. Cabbages perhaps attempting to do that, but stopped by Wagner, who hits the massive power slam. Hayes now in the ring. Reversed by, or Hayes reverses Wagner. Cabbages, not sure what he was going for there, but didn't quite pan out. Hayes reverses. Axiom now back to the ring. Still been a long time since we've seen anybody attempt to retrieve the title here. Cabbages, the first and so far only a man to attempt to retrieve the title, breaking one of the locks. As he'll head outside once again. Axiom now with a ladder. He sets it up. And with everybody else down or distracted, Von Wagner is going to be the second man. Try to unhook the title, but won't even get to start. Ladder collapsing underneath him. Cabbages was a confirmed handshake, but broken up by Axiom, who hits the suplex. Hayes back to the ring. He's going to set up the ladder, but not to try to retrieve his championship in the corner as a weapon. Wagner taken out by Hayes. We have a really zoomed in camera right now. Cabbages and Wagner with a temporary alliance to take out the defending champion with a DDT. Both Wagner and Axiom have head injuries now. Axiom sent onto that ladder, and Cabbages with a suicide dive onto the ladder, taking out Axiom. What a huge move by Cabbages. High risk, high reward. Now a green mist by Cabbages, and a punt kick to Wagner. Two men down, one to go. It's the defending champion, Hayes. Backbreaker. But now Axiom back to his feet and bringing another weapon into play. It's going to be another ladder. Hayes, barely fazed by Cabbages' offense, kips up and dumps Cabbages on the outside. Hayes now the only man in the ring. He has an opportunity here. Now Axiom in the ring as well, as is Cabbages. Not even sure where Wagner is. Oh, there he is. He was on the outside. Yet another green mist by Cabbages to the injured head of Axiom. There's Wagner. And he sends Cabbages into the ladder, stunning him. Now only two men on their feet. They are Hayes and Wagner fighting in the ring. Axiom back to the ring. Cabbages back to his feet, heading back into the ring. Snake eyes to Axiom by Wagner. Cabbages takes out Axiom. Now has the ladder. Not quite sure he set up in the right position. We'll see. Cabbages was thinking firm handshake, but reversal by Hayes, and a drop kick takes out Cabbages. and Wagner, with everybody else down or fighting, will ascend the ladder. And tries to start unhooking it, but Cabbages powerbombs him, and Axiom will collapse the ladder. We are including entrances 20 minutes into this match, and only one of the locks has been unhooked. Only Cabbages has had an opportunity to play the mini game to unhook the belt. Everybody else that's attempted to has been thwarted in their attempts. Cabbages drop kicked by Axiom. Cabbages sent outside. So is Axiom. Wagner with a big boot to Hayes. Opportunity for Wagner if he wants to go after the belt. Indeed, that is what he's going to try to do, it appears. Wagner slowly sends the ladder with Hayes down and Cabbages and Axiom fighting on the outside. Wagner. Unhooks the second lock. Now Hayes begins to ascend the ladder. Axiom trying to push the ladder down. Hayes, with a massive code breaker, sends Wagner to the outside. And now Hayes will begin to ascend the ladder once again. As will Cabbages. NXT Universe chanting, "This is awesome." Axiom going after Hayes. And now just trying to collapse the ladder on both Cabbages and Hayes. Hayes with another massive code breaker. Stuns Cabbages. Hayes showing out, doing anything he can to remain North American champion. You have to applaud his effort here. Now Hayes and Axiom on top of the ladder. Wagner trying to collapse it, but struggling to. Cabbages takes out Wagner. Axiom and Hayes playing on top of the ladder. Cabbages and Wagner are down. Axiom with a massive opportunity here. All opponents are down. And he's going to try to retrieve the title here. We might have a new North American champion in Axiom as Wagner and Cabbages start to stir to their feet. But it's going to be too little too late. Axiom retrieves the belt. It is your new NXT North American champion. Okay, and we had a great opening match with Axiom being crowned the new NXT North American champion. Carmelo Hayes' second or third title reign ends after just about a month or so. Cabbages unfortunately failing in his attempt to regain the title. And Axiom is your new NXT North American champion. That was just the first of three WITM matches as we now move to our one non-title match that we have for you. But it is a big one, as we are finally going to see the Falcon Claws versus the Smile Society with both men unmasked. It is going to be Corey's return to in-ring action, unless you count him facing Darth as a masked man, taking on the one member of the Smile Society that has been revealed so far, the man who turned on Corey's deal to spy on the Smile Society to join them himself, Cowboy Cameron Grimes, who I made a custom attire and entrance for. Corey, with a new attire and a slightly tweaked moveset as well, struggled a lot before his hiatus. Can Corey get back to the win column here and get some revenge over Cameron Grimes? And anything goes, no holds barred contest. Weapons are in play. Let's find out and get our second of three WITM matches underway.
Thank you.
There's the battle. This match is underway in Corey's final act on NXT before fully giving control of the NXT Falcon Claws to Cabbages. Corey trying to get some revenge on Cameron Grimes. Both men debuting new attires that I made for them. Cameron Grimes with a custom attire representing the colors of the Smile Society and new entrance attire as well. In their colors and with the smiley faces. Corey's attire is inspired by the attire that the late Zims / Austin made for Corey in his universe. Altered a little bit from the one that Corey was using. Corey wasting no time bringing weapons into play. The steel steps brought into play as Corey early on unloading on Cameron Grimes. But there's a reversal by Grimes. Corey shoves Grimes aside and hits the bicycle kick, a move he was struggling to get to connect prior to his hiatus. There is another boot by Corey, and he goes for cover. And Grimes powers out at one. Corey blocks the grapple attempt by Grimes. And spikes him in the air before hitting the fastball punch. Grimes trying to get back to his feet here using the ropes, but puts himself in a vulnerable position. The Tree of Woe, or rather seated in the corner, but is able to shove the boot of Corey aside and send him down to canvas. Corey shoves Grimes aside and hits the bicycle kick again. Corey already showing much better in-ring ability than he had prior to his hiatus. And now bring another weapon into play. It's going to be a table. And the NXT Universe fully in Corey's corner. They want to see Cameron Grimes go through a table after everything he and the Smile Society have put the Falcon Claws through over the last month. There's an arm drag by Grimes. And a slap by Grimes. Corey forced to the corner. Grimes using the top rope to wear down the arm of Corey. Now Grimes bulldogs Corey with his knee catching the edge of that table. And now a knee to the head. Corey is able to evade. Corey giving Grimes tape his own medicine, showing him how it's done. The knee to the head. Grimes is busted open. Corey unloading and out for revenge here. Now Corey with the roundabout, his signature maneuver. And cross face locked in. We're going to see Grimes tap here. We know his head is injured. It's locked in well. Is Grimes going to tap? No, he finally breaks the hold, but he's at risk of injury. His head bloodied and in the red zone. Arm drag by Grimes. Corey. With repeated kicks to chest and a massive roundhouse to the blade head. Another roundabout. And another crossfade. Grimes taps out. Corey's back to the win column and gets his revenge over the Smile Society and Cameron Grimes in his final act in NXT. Corey much improved since his hiatus. Last but not least, is your main event of the evening is going to be Tony D'Angelo, a man who has been dominant over almost all of WITM Season 8. He's the NXT champion, a belt that he unified with the NXT UK championship held previously by one of his opponents here tonight, Ilya Dragunov, who gets his rematch here tonight, but he will have only a 33% champion chance of revenge as Tyger Brown, a man who also is looking for redemption as he previously had an NXT championship shot, but was injured and ended up having to forfeit the opportunity, but he gets his chance here. He won a number one contenders match to earn this opportunity, and Tony D'Angelo will only have a 33% chance of extending his impressive reign as he takes on Tyger Brown and the former United Kingdom champion Ilya Dragunov. Can Tyger Brown, a former North American champion, add the NXT championship to his impressive time and impressive resume on NXT? Let's find out and get our main event underway.
From Chicago, Illinois, weighing in 240 pounds.
And there's the bell. Our main event for the NXT Championship is underway. Triple threat. Another anything goes match of all of our matches have been. Or WITM matches have been in this episode. Which man is leaving with the NXT Championship? Dragunov with a master suplex to Brown. D'Angelo with a takedown on Dragunov. D'Angelo still carrying the United Kingdom Championship to the ring that he won from Dragunov, perhaps trying to send a message to him. As Dragunov with a series of elbows. And now a massive setup powerbomb to Brown. D'Angelo with a drop kick. Brown heads to the outside. Now D'Angelo striking away, takes out Dragunov. And now heads to the corner. And to the top rope. Elbow drop connects on the head of Dragunov. Brown back to the ring. Stretching the back and arm of D'Angelo, but D'Angelo reverses. Brown kips up and hits a suplex into a cover, broken up immediately by Dragunov. Reversal by Brown. Dragunov with a DDT into a cover. Opportunity for Dragunov, but Brown powers out at one. Dragunov with a suplex. Brown heads to the outside as D'Angelo hits the snake eyes on Dragunov. Brown back into the ring. Reversal by D'Angelo. Reversal by Brown with an elbow. Massive bulldog busts open the NXT champion D'Angelo. And now D'Angelo and Brown with a temporary alliance to double DDT Dragunov. And now Brown with a suplex to D'Angelo. Headbutt by D'Angelo. Crossbody by Dragunov. And now snake eyes by Brown, but a massive clothesline by D'Angelo. And a variation of a rock bottom by D'Angelo. Browns his body in the red zone. We've seen that body suffer damage over his last couple of matches. Could it be a factor here? Dragunov with a suplex to Brown. Elbow strike by D'Angelo. Opportunity here for D'Angelo to retain with both men down, but they both quickly get back to their feet. Suplex stuns Dragunov, and he's on the outside. D'Angelo and Brown collide in the middle of the ring. And now D'Angelo with the snake eyes to Brown. And this is a no-holds-barred match. Dragunov bringing a kendo stick into play. It is all legal here in a triple threat matchup. And he takes out Brown with it. But Brown is able to knock it out of the hands of Dragunov. Now Brown with a massive powerbomb. And now Brown launched behind Dragunov. All three men at risk of injury. Dragunov striking away as D'Angelo looks to bring another weapon into play. Brown with leg kicks. Another kendo stick brought into play. Cracked over the head of Brown. Who goes for cover. Great opportunity for D'Angelo with Dragunov stunned. But Brown powers out at 2.5. D'Angelo in shock. He thought that'd be enough to keep his title reign alive. Now D'Angelo rubbing the face of Dragunov across the top rope. And there's Brown with a DDT. Brown with a clothesline, but there's D'Angelo. And they collide in the center. Brown taking out both men, butting their heads against each other. And a powerbomb by Brown, but there's a clothesline from the back by Dragunov to take out Brown. D'Angelo bring another kendo stick into play. Now they find the outside, which they can do as long as they want. No countouts in this matchup. Brown with a massive powerbomb to Dragunov. Now D'Angelo sent back into the ring as Brown turns focus back to Dragunov. And there's another powerbomb. Brown taken out by D'Angelo. Dragunov and D'Angelo fighting on the outside. D'Angelo sent back to the ring. Dragunov sent back to the ring. Brown taunting and biding his time as D'Angelo works the ankle of Dragunov. And goes for cover, broken up right away by Brown. Who has three finishers built up. Nobody else has a single finisher built up. But Brown can hit all three on multiple opponents. He may become an NXT champion. Dragunov with a DDT. Brown sent to the outside. D'Angelo sends Dragunov into the corner, but he gets out. And D'Angelo with that rock bottom variation again, but there's Brown. Clothesline by Brown, both men down. This is a great opportunity for Brown as he attacks the arm of D'Angelo. Now a set up powerbomb, stunning Brown. Brown drops looking for that 450. It connects. As Dragunov taunts, Brown goes for cover. And D'Angelo, they have a power out at two. Brown in shock. That's our second near fall of the matchup. What is it going to take? All three men have suffered immense punishment already in this matchup. As Dragunov brings the kendo stick back into play. And D'Angelo stunning Dragunov. Now Brown takes out D'Angelo. And is looking for another weapon. It's going to be a steel chair. But D'Angelo goes for cover. Broken up by Brown. Brown with a knee to D'Angelo. Pele kick to Dragunov. And a knee as D'Angelo taunts on the outside. Brown continues to punish Dragunov. Now repeated stomps to the chest. D'Angelo missing with his attack. Brown bending the ankles of D'Angelo. That's gotta hurt. And now sending them into the canvas. And hitting a massive big boot. And a double leg drop. Now Brown can take flight. But Dragunov trying to cut him down. Brown hits the axe handle. And now goes after D'Angelo with Dragunov recovering on the outside. Stretching the back and arms. Brown has been focusing on the limbs of his opponents. Dragunov back in. And breaks the hold, but a lot of damage done to D'Angelo. Dragunov with a massive setup powerbomb, stunning Brown. Great opportunity for Dragunov. He's going to bring the kendo stick back into play. And goes after Tyger Brown. Brown trying to use Dark Souls strategies here and dodge roll out of the way. And takes out Dragunov. Now they find the outside. spinebuster by D'Angelo. Dragunov taunts D'Angelo, tells him to bring it, and bring it he does. Dragunov taken out. D'Angelo grabs a kendo stick. But crossbody by Dragunov knocks out of his hands. Dragunov is sent back into the ring. Tyger sent back to the ring. Reversal by Brown. Bulldog by Dragunov. Brown sent to the outside. Suplex by D'Angelo. And another suplex. Brown back to the ring. Misses with his punch. D'Angelo lands his. Ash up to the ropes. Spinebuster by D'Angelo. And now D'Angelo looking for a finisher. And that will connect that rock bottom variation once again. But broken up. Suplex by D'Angelo. And another into a cover, broken up by Brown. Brown with a suplex. And now Brown looking to take flight. Another kendo stick brought into play by Dragunov. 450 splash misses, and Dragunov punishes him right away. And now D'Angelo punishing Brown. Looks like it's a double team on Brown, perhaps. And Brown with a reversal. Dragunov has a steel chair. That's going to be knocked out of the hands of Dragunov by Brown, who hits repeated elbow strikes. Opportunity here for Brown. He's going to take it. He goes for cover. And becomes the new NXT champion. And Tyger cashes in this opportunity with the odds against him. And is the NXT champion. Okay, and here is your results and rankings update for NXT Halloween Havoc. In our opening matchup, the NXT North American title was on the line in a fatal four-way ladder match, and we saw a new champion crowned as Axiom defeated Von Wagner, Cabbages, and the former North American champion Carmelo Hayes to become the new NXT North American champion. Then we saw Corey get his revenge in his final appearance on NXT over the Smile Society's Cameron Grimes. Corey looking much improved in his official return to action. Then we saw two former stablemates clash against each other, with Julius Creed defeating Damon Kemp. And then we saw two former tag team partners clash, with Roxanne Perez getting revenge over Cora Jade, who abandoned their tag teams and the NXT Women's Champion, the NXT Women's Tag Team Champions earlier in the year, to pursue the NXT Women's Championship. And then in the main event, we saw Tyger Brown, the man who loves to collect gold, become the new NXT Championship and add another belt to his collection as he defeated Ilya Dragunov and the former NXT champion Tony D'Angelo, who lost the title without even being involved in the decision, as it was Dragunov that Brown pinned. Brown is your new NXT champion, and after a month of hell getting attacked by the Smile Society, Cabbage's time as the leader of the NXT Falcon Claw is getting off to a great start, as all of the men under him, now draped in gold with Tyger, Brown, Darth, and Sword all being champions. And how does that affect the rankings on NXT? Let's find out. The NXT Women's Tag Team Champions are Katana Chance and Kayden Carter. Number one contenders, Valentina Feroz and Alyssa Leon. Number two, Toxic Attraction. The NXT Women's Champion is Blair Davenport. Number one contender, Roxanne Perez. Number two, Mandy Rose. Number three, Ariana Grace. Excuse me. Number four, Nikita Lyons. Number five, Cora Jade. Number six, Lash Legend. Number seven, Miko Satomura. Number eight, Alba Fire. Number nine, Tiffany Stratton. Number 10, Indy Hartwell. Number 11, Ivy Nile. Number 12, Tatum Paxley. Number 13, Fallon Henley. Number 14, Taya Hale. Number 15, Wendy Chu. Number 16, Zoe Stark. The NXT Tag Team Champions are Darth and Sword of the NXT Falcon Claw. Number contenders, the Creed Brothers. Number 2, Pretty Deadly. Number 3, Gallus. Number 4, Jensen and Briggs. Number 5, Anofe and Blade. Number 6, The Dyad, representing Schism. The NXT North American Champion is Axiom. Number 1 contender, Wes Lee. Number 2, Cabbages. Number 3, Trick Williams. Number 4, Grayson Waller. Number 5, Von Wagner. Number 6, Damon Kemp. And number 7, Nathan Frazier. The NXT Champion is Tyger Brown. Number 1 contender, Bron Breakker. Number 2, Ilya Dragunov. Number 3, Apollo Crews. Number 4, Carmella Hayes, moving up to the NXT Championship Division after his North American title reign came to an end. Number 5, Duke Hudson. Number 6, Joe Gacy. Number 7, J.D. McDonough. Number 8, Tyler Bate. Number 9, Cameron Grimes. Number 10, Andre Chase. And number 11, the former champion, Tony D'Angelo, going from the top of the division as champion straight to the bottom. Not a good night for Tony D'Angelo, who wasn't even involved in the decision in the match. So now we advance to Monday Night Raw. Will we see the return of Corey to Monday Night Raw? And will we see Alec Winterbourne, E-Rock, and maybe Queen Opaka, who's been out of action for a while? We will find out in just a moment. And yes, on Monday Night Raw, we will see the continuation of the rivalry between the Judgment Day and the Raw Falcon Claws, but with a little bit of a twist. Is going to be a rivalry match involving cutscenes with Dominic Mysterio of the Judgment Day and Ye Rock of the Falcon Claws. We've seen a lot of tag team matches between these men, but now it's going to be Ye Rock and Dominic Mysterio one-on-one in a rivalry match. That should be interesting and will be your matchup for episode number 33. Also, we will see Corey on the microphone in his return to Monday Night Raw addressing what his future plans are now that he is back on Monday Night Raw and has returned from his hiatus. But that is going to do it for episode number 32. If you enjoyed it, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single moment of WITM action. Be sure to check out our Twitch channels and our W codes in the description of this video. Until episode number 33, where Ye Rock takes on Dominic Mysterio in a rivalry match, and we hear from the returning Corey on the microphone in his return to Monday Night Raw. This is Corey with WITM Call Wrestling, signing off.